And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our minus 60 kilogram ISKA European title defense. Please welcome to the blue corner from Scotland, it's Sophie Gallagher! Sophie Gallagher! And please welcome to the red corner from London, England, it's Annabelle Shelley! Gentlemen, this full tie rules bout will take place in the minus 60 kilogram division and will be contested over 5 2-minute rounds. Introducing to you firstly, fighting out of the blue corner, representing SMTC Gym in Glasgow, Scotland, please give a warm welcome to Sophie Gallagher! And across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, representing Team Two and Kettles Gym in England, please welcome Annabelle, the Princess Killer, Shelley!
Okay, we're moving on to our second fight of the main card. It's a ladies' bout, featuring Sophie Gallagher of SMTC Scotland and Annabella Gelly of Team Two and Kettles Gym here in England. I'm joined by the world champion, Miss Iman Barlow herself.
Yeah, this is going to be a great fight tonight. It's the second ladies' fight of the night. Don't think I've seen either of them fight, but I have seen their stuff on Facebook and they're both strong.
Yeah, I've seen Sophie fight before. She fought on one of the Smash shows, from what I remember, against girl from Touch Gloves, and I haven't seen Annabella fight since she was at KO many years ago.
Yeah, I think she's fought on a Team 2 show not long ago.
Good body kick there from Sophie Gallagher.
Annabelle seems to be quite wide open, elbow stuck out wide.
Yeah, she's framing her face, walking open with that rather than in a traditional stance.
I suppose they're just kind of testing the waters at the minute.
Yeah, it's early doors in this 5 2-minute round A-class competition.
That body shot looked like it hurt Sophie, actually.
Yeah. Sophie there trying to wrap up the arm of Gelly there to stop her throwing the elbow.
Yeah, that's the thing when you fight A-class, you just got to watch out for the elbows and keep tight at all times, especially in the clinch.
Yeah, you try and make them understand that. If you can elbow them, they can certainly elbow you. Annabelle's hands have come down now. She's kind of adopted bit of a lower stance. I think she's gained a little bit of confidence.
Yeah, I think she's confident as well. Always pushing forward. I think Sophie needs to do the body kicks. That's what was working at the beginning of the round. It's the end of the round.
Okay, here we go, round two.
This is a time when the girls have gone back to their corners and kind of got a bit of a telling off or a words of advice.
Yeah, I'd like to see one of them sort of take control and take centre ring rather and follow each other around the ropes. At this sort of level, they should both be, you know.
Yeah, just kind of stand there and fight.
Annabelle has definitely gained in confidence.
Them knees.
Yeah, Sophie needs to negate them legs. She needs to lock her leg out to stop her elbowing. Stop her knee and lock the arms to stop the elbow.
I want to see Sophie do more body kicks and head kicks and just keep kicking. Seems what she's good at. She's got big, nice, strong legs.
Annabella's fairly relentless. She's just coming forward, walking her down all the time. So Sophie needs to do something. She needs to hit and either take a step backwards or hit and move off to the side.
Yeah, like I say, Muay Thai has scored on effect, and if she's going backwards while being hit...
Yeah, well, obviously, it presumes bigger effect.
Yeah.
She needs to work in that clinch.
Yeah, she's just kind of trying to stop it, isn't she?
Yeah, she's trying to negate it, but obviously she can't lock the leg off well enough.
She's a twist round, use the footwork and knee.
She needs to get off that rope, come back, start centering.
Seem to like the clinch, these two. Well, Annabelle.
Yeah, most of the girls that I've seen come from that KO kind of style. She used to be stablemates with Anna Zakelli, the world champion. Very similar, to walk you down, grabbing the clinch, and knee, 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 throw elbow, grab, knee, knee. Never stand at range. Yeah. So.
Well, if that's where she's winning, then she'll just carry on and do it.
Yeah, of course. Okay, round three. This intriguing ladies' contest.
We should be picking it up now, round three.
Yeah, definitely. This is better from Sophie Gallagher.
Good headshots there, that's why...
She needs to stop backing off, she needs to stand the ground.
I think she'll do well if she stands still and kicks, punches to the head. Because Annabelle's dropping her hands.
Again, there's Annabelle looking for that big clinch. Relentless walking forward, just trying to grab hold and strike and clinch.
Look how low her hands come down though.
Yeah, you know, it only takes one shot, done it on the sweet spot.
Yeah.
A big head kick and...
That's it. Yeah, she knows that she's winning in the clinch. She feels that she's strong, so she's just going for the clinch.
Yeah. Certainly in a position like that, she should have been knee in the back, though.
Yeah.
See, Sophie seems to stop working in the middle of the round. Just kind of goes back and waits to get hit.
Yeah, she's getting tired, you can see it.
Yeah. Wincing then with a shot across the arms. Locking the leg off, not wanting to negate that clinch completely.
You can hear Alan Kendall shouting pressure, and that's what she's doing. Annabelle's just putting pressure on her and slowly grinding her down.
Sophie needs to kick. She needs to kick and punch. She's just sort of stood still waiting for Annabelle to walk onto her. I don't know how much of this clinch has actually taken on Sophie and how much it's tired her. She doesn't look like she's particularly tired coming back to a corner.
No, she looks all right. I think she looks frustrated. She doesn't know what to do. Everything she's doing is not really working.
If you were in a corner, man, what would you be telling her to do right now?
If I was in Sophie's corner, I'd tell her to be using her footwork, move around, and kind of use her footwork and kick when Annabelle comes forward.
Yeah, no, I totally agree. I think she needs to hold position a little bit more, though, because she bounces back and puts all the weight on her back foot, and then she can't do anything from that point.
Yeah, definitely. She needs to stay in the centre of the ring as well and take the fight to her.
Okay, moving into round four. These are called the money rounds in Muay Thai.
All or nothing.
That's the one. Sophie starts really well, like you say. But again, Annabelle just marches forward, stops her being able to kick, and straight into that clinch.
Yeah, she brings the knees up high and then swings them in. A lot of power.
Yeah, definitely.
Power and exaggeration. Oh, elbow on the top of the head by Annabelle.
Some fighters get really overwrought of worrying about where the hands are in the clinch rather than just relaxing and getting on with kneeing.
Yeah, and kind of going with the flow.
Yeah. A good body kick then from Annabelle.
Her hands are so low, she's so lucky.
I think she thinks she's got the measure of the Scottish girl. Well, like we say, only takes one shot.
She's just fighting, going backwards now, Sophie. It's not.
I don't even know if she's fighting, Iman. I think she's just going backwards. She kind of goes back and waits to get hit again, rather than going back and counter-striking.
Yeah.
She sort of backs off, pauses, and thinks, right, what are you going to hit me with next?
And both of these are number one at their different weights, aren't they?
Yeah, they are.
I think it's Annabelle at the lighter weight.
Yeah, and Sophie's number one at the heavier weight.
Yeah, the way she's just putting pressure on her.
I think Annabelle starts to run away with this now.
Yeah, I agree. I think she's won all four rounds.
Yeah, I mean, for me, the only way Sophie can turn this round is if she drops her and then stops her. I don't even think a knockdown in round five would be enough to turn the fight completely around.
No, yeah, I agree. But she needs to get kicking.
Yeah, definitely. Take centre of the ring, plant her feet, wait for her to come forward, strike to the with the body kicks, step off, do it again. Rather than back and wait to get hit.
Yeah, I agree.
Fifth and final round.
Okay, fifth and final round in this 5-2's A-class contest. Annabelle Gelly seems to have taken the previous rounds quite convincingly. Sophie's kind of come alive now. But maybe too little, too late.
Yeah. So I mean, sometimes you need a few rounds to warm up, but sometimes it's just a bit too late. Sophie needs to keep out the clinch.
Yeah.
My legs are twitching for her.
She knows what Annabelle's going to do. She's had four rounds of it. So, you know, she needs to find angles. That's it. Better move off. Stay away from the ropes and actually fight back.
That's it. Better.
That's better.
Body kicks.
Annabelle landing a good body kick of her own. Sophie wincing as that went in.
Some sneaky elbows going in there.
Yeah, very. This is better by Sophie Gallagher. Much better.
Ooh, and there.
Another elbow there by Gelly.
Gelly fell out the ring.
Hey,
Annabelle's just relentless, just pushing forward all the time.
Yeah, it's I think it's a very much a KO trait that all the girls from there seem to have fought the same way all the way through the careers for everyone I've ever seen. They're just relentless, forward, forward, forward. Yeah. And obviously she moved over to Team Chu and the expertise of Alan Kettle.
Warrior's heart, just pushing forward, no matter what.
Well, I think it's safe to say that that's a clear win to the red corner.
Yeah, I think Annabelle smashed it, won that easy.
After those five rounds of action, your judges have reached a unanimous decision. All in favour of your winner, fighting out of the red corner, it's Annabelle, the Princess Killer, Jelly! And show your appreciation for our runner-up, Sophie Gallagher!